So in order to make holes in your object in Mesh Mixer, we're going to be using a couple different tools: drop solid, transform, and Boolean difference. So in order to start this one, I would recommend having the objects browser open. So in order to do that, if it isn't already open, you can go up to the view menu up in the top left and either click show objects browser or do control shift O, and that will open the browser here. This window here allows you to see any models that are in the program open at the current time. So this will be helpful later when there will end up being multiple objects here. So first off, I'm just going to reposition this so you can get a better view of it. So in order to make a hole, what I usually tend to do is use a cylinder shape. So in order to do that, up in the menu over in the left here, you'll see that there is an option called Mesh Mix. So if you click on that, it will bring up a menu of several different shapes. So these are any sort of shapes that you can actually add to your model to either remove them or append them or to make new objects together. So I'm going to use this cylinder shape right here. You'll just click and drag it onto your model wherever you would like the hole to be. So if you just click and drag, I'm just going to try to place it here. And as you can see, you end up with a really large object that isn't quite positioned correctly. So in order to position this a little bit better, you can click on this little white circle here right in the center. It will turn purple. And as you can see, as you drag it around, it will try to reposition it based on the surface that it's sitting on. So it doesn't have to be perfect because you can move this later on. But right now, I'm just going to kind of set it right here. There are a couple different options for editing this in this menu. The dimensions will make the object larger or smaller. I'm just going to make it a little bit smaller. And this you can edit later on, so don't worry too much about how this looks right now. The offset will raise and lower the object. This can be useful here, but for some models, depending on the size of the hole you're wanting to make, this offset won't exactly solve the problem of making sure that the hole goes all the way through the object if that's what you're aiming for. So right now, the other thing you really have to make sure that you have checked is under the composition mode over in the menu here, you have a couple different options. Append to mesh will attach this shape to your other shape. Create new object will set the cylinder shape as a separate object from the hand. Boolean union will attach the two files together and make them into one object. And then Boolean subtract will remove this object. That is one way to make a hole, but I'm going to show you a way that gives you a little bit more control over the size and shape of what you're wanting to make. So for here, I'm just going to choose create new object. And when I'm ready, just press accept. And what you'll see happens now is over in the objects browser, we now have two files. We have the full hand, which is the hand file, and then we have the dropped part, which you'll see here is the cylinder. So this is why it's better to have this open so that you can see both objects together. So for right now, I'm actually going to keep the drop part selected. And then what I'm going to do is you click on the edit menu and then go to transform. And you'll get the same control options that you got previously with the transform tool. Now what this will let you do is resize the cylinder to however large you want it to be. And again, you can either use the shapes here to resize your object, or you can use the menu here and type in the numbers you would like if you have an exact size and shape you would like it to be. So for here, I'm just going to kind of resize using these here to make it a little bit more narrow. So, for example, here, I think that this is a pretty good size for this. Now, the other thing you have to make sure that you're noticing is that it is in the center of where you want it to be. So, say, for example, I would like the hole to be here, but as you'll notice that it isn't going completely through the object. So, for here, I'm going to have to make it taller. So, in order to make sure that you get a hole that goes completely through this object here, you have to make sure that the cylinder goes completely through as well. So I'm just going to reposition it a little bit so that it's in the center. And here, I kind of like how this looks. It's gone completely through, and I know that this will make a complete hole. So once you're done, you'll press accept, and that will accept the changes. So the last thing you have to do is erase this from the hand file. Now, in order to do that, you'll see right now that we have the dropped part still highlighted in the objects browser. So what you actually will need to do is click off of that and highlight the hand file instead. Now, you're going to have both files selected to do the subtract, but what happens is whichever file you have selected first is the file that will stay, while the second file that you select will be the part that is subtracted. So if you want to keep the hand and subtract the cylinder, you will click the hand first and then click the dropped part. So in order to do that, click on the full hand file, press the shift key, and then click on the dropped part. And as you can see now, I have both of them selected, and everything is gray here. And I'll get a new menu that pops up on the left side here. So the one that you're going to want to use is Boolean difference. So you have a couple options here. Boolean union, again, will make both of these files into one file. It will connect them together, and they'll be, it'll add this cylinder to this model. But Boolean difference will actually subtract. So you'll click here. And what you'll see is this is a preview. So you'll see here that you've got the hand now in purple, and then where the cylinder was, you have it in orange. And this just gives you a good preview of what your hole will look like before you accept. So this will give you an idea of if you like this to be here, if it's too large, if it's too small. That will give you a chance to edit it, because you can actually just press cancel if you want to undo that, and it will bring the file back like this, and then you have a chance to do it again. So I'm just going to press Boolean difference once more. So say that I'm happy with this. You can actually press accept, and you'll notice here that there are still two files in the objects browser. But once I press accept, now there's only one file. So what it's done is Boolean difference has combined the two files while subtracting the second file, so while subtracting the cylinder. So you can actually do this with any of the shapes here. So if you want to do a circle, a ring, a cone, there are actually quite a few different shapes in this menu here that you can play with. And this is a good way to make holes in your objects. And you can make as many holes as you want, or to add different shapes to your objects if you have some reason to do that. So I encourage you to try both adding and subtracting files to your model, and seeing what happens.